everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and I am out trimming trees. It's a little bit late in the year, but better late than never and before it gets too late.
So what are you starting on now?
Well, this is a plum tree that has not had plums in ages. I can't even remember the last time I had plums, so I'm hoping if I trim it a little bit, perhaps it'll get inspired.
Yeah, you've been doing trimming all right.
Yep, these are off of that apple tree that's over yonder that is getting...
In the raised bed?
Yep, and when we planted it, we thought it was a pear tree. Turned out to have great apples on it, but it was getting too hard to get around it so that I could get to the garden. So I trimmed that a little bit. Now I'm working on this one. Last year, I grew morning glories in it. So it looks like it's decorated because those are all the old morning glory vines. Hmm.
So, and then are you going to work on the honeysuckle and the clematis?
I need a ladder for those guys.
Maybe I can help.
Okay. Now this is a honeysuckle vine that, as you can see, we've had for many, many years. I mean, it's really, it's braided itself. It's just kind of gotten out of control, as they do. Now, we always wanted it to go up over the pergola, but it's, honeysuckles are messy. And, well, we're just going to do some trimming.
I think we'll take it off about that level.
We're going to take it out right under this big knot right here, but we'll leave what's left here.
Well, you can see all the new growth starting mm-hmm. to come onto it, so.
Right, and that's on new branches. You know, this is a lifeline, I'm guessing. So I guess I'll just start slowly and do it vine by vine.
I think you'll be able to make a nice wreath. I think you need to use a lopper.
Oh, that's a little one. I don't know about this side shoot. I don't like this guy over here, so no. He's coming off.
Take it off.
Off you go. Now, another thing we're going to be trimming is this clematis, or clematis, however you pronounce that. This is a beautiful one, but you can see it's hanging way down. It'd be easier with a head trimmer.
Yeah.
Or a scissors, because they're not that large of a branch. Little by little. It's like giving somebody a haircut. I'm cutting off the ponytail. Come here.
Progress.
There's some seeds.
Yep.
This guy was blooming all the way to November, wasn't it?
Oh, yes, it was. And you even had this on a little trellis support here, too.
Yes.
Forgot about those.
Oh, we couldn't even see them.
Well, while we're here, let's just go around the corner and show that other little clematis. That you're also going to have to be trimming.
Right, we have three of them here. Some of them, I guess you're not supposed to trim at all, and the other one dies back down to the ground.
Yeah, but the one right around the corner, that one we may have to trim.
It's talking about this guy?
Yep. Just to get some of that old stuff off. Unless you can want to just tie it up.
Mm. You know, it's really hard to tell what's alive and what isn't, so. Take some off. I mean, they're not like they're prized specimens. We just like them and they seem pretty and they grew nicely here.
Well, they did start kind of clogging up this entrance way though.
Yes, they did. Better already. Quite a difference. Didn't take too long either. There'll be a lot more sun on this pergola. And I see another trip to the recycling center in our near future. Well, we're going a little bit higher with this one, or should I say lower. We're going to take it down to the top of the trellis. Scissors are working much better. There you go. Well, while we were out here trimming, we wanted to take a look at the kiwi vine that we planted last year. And this is the one that has little kiwi-like grape-size fruits on it. And it was a...
twig.
It was a twig, right, when we planted it. And it's not hardy for really, really cold winter. So we placed it on the south side of a house and we surrounded it with straw for the winter. It's really warm in that straw area, but you can see it's definitely going to need another trellis section.
Well.
It is a vine. Oh, decisions. Rubbing.
You gonna plant more morning glories back here?
No.
Tim's gonna wanna know why not.
Tim knows why not.
You heard it here, Tim.
Morning glory.
They were in their glory, that's for sure.
They were beautiful. I have to admit, they were beautiful.
Yep.
If you tie something onto a tree with a twisty and then never untie it, you block it off.
You girdle it.
Like that. Yep.
I'd cut that whole branch off.
This one?
Yep.
Kind of would poke your eyeball out if you weren't careful.
Yep.
I can reach you.
Are we 6 feet apart?
How about this one?
Yep.
I still have a little bit more trimming to do, but then it's a matter of cleaning up everything that I've trimmed, putting into a size that I can move and carry over to the trailer, and eventually we'll get to the recycling center, maybe tomorrow in between raindrops. Who knows?
Next week. Mm-hmm. There's no rush.
So
still have some apple trees in the front too.
They
have some crossing.
Yes, and we've got a couple in the back here too.
Yep. But I think everybody gets the idea.
Yes. And it's a nice day, so we're doing it. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We truly appreciate it. And if you have comments, questions, or tips, we'd love to hear about them.
Come on over and cut for us.
Yeah, if you want to go, we'll stay 6 feet away from you. Thank you for watching. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, there's that little button over here somewhere.
Way down in the corner.
And you can just click that and you will be subscribed to our channel.
And part of our garden family.
Yes. Thanks again. Stay safe. Bye.
Connect with us on YouTube.